Hello, friends and family. Welcome back to my channel. And if you guys are new here, I am so happy that you are here. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on that post notification button. That way you are notified for every future video that I post and turn or give this video a big thumbs up. And grab that cup of coffee. And here we are watching and awaiting for our Jesus Christ to return and come and grab us and rapture us out of here before this big tribulation starts. And we have a lot of frustrating things to talk about today, so let's go. Sadly, most people think that to get to heaven, you just have to be a good person. And that is the biggest number one lie from the enemy. So before we get going, we're going to settle this really quick. Before we get going, I think it's one of the most important things that we need to talk about is the gospel. So in order to get to heaven, you have to have a relationship with Jesus Christ. He is the way, the truth, and the life, and no one can get to the Father but through him. And in order to be saved and have a relationship with him, we have to first admit that we are a sinner. We all sin. We are all infected with this virus called sin. And we live in a fallen world because that happened from Adam and Eve in the beginning. And it's just been our world since. So none of us can live up to God's standards because he is pure and holy. Once you admit that you are a sinner, you need to confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord. You need to believe in your heart and your mind and your soul. Not just believe and say that you believe, but truly believe that Jesus is your Lord and that he came down and left his throne of glory to die on the cross for you, for your sins, so that we could live forever with him. That he, when he died on the cross, and then he was rose from the dead on the third day, and that he is coming back again for us. And you know, you just have to confess with your mouth that he is Lord and believe, and it's all, we're saved by grace and faith alone, not by works. So all of the ABCs of salvation are all in the description box below, and also links if you want to say the prayer with me. There's video links too, you can say it. I know a lot of people just still don't know exactly what to say or how to pray, so you can say it with me if you'd like. Things are ramping up. Things are speeding up. Tomorrow isn't promised, even if the rapture isn't coming for another few months. Tomorrow is never promised. Do not wait until tomorrow. Accept Jesus today. He just wants a relationship with you. Again, everything's in the description box. Don't wait. Accept him today. I am so frustrated. Okay. So what happened? Well, America, we do not live in a free country anymore, as many of you have already, many of you already know that. They're silencing us completely, and I've been sharing some videos, especially on my other platforms, of other people being silenced. It's starting to happen to me now. I want to show you some things that just happened to me. Okay, so I was just scrolling through and I saw this girl, and I'm going to show you exactly everything that happened. So this girl here, she's a Christian, and she's very adamant about her political beliefs, which we should be able to. The left is very adamant about their political beliefs and protests. So I don't know why we can't talk about our side. But anyways, so here's her video.
If I say all lives matter, I'm a racist. If I stand for my flag, I have to apologize for it. I'm not allowed to go to church, but I can burn churches to the ground. I'm not allowed to open my own business, but I can go loot and destroy other people's businesses. If I wear a badge, have a gun, and I'm dressed in blue, I'm a racist pig. But if I walk around destroying my city with bricks and masks, I'm considered a peaceful protester. I'm not allowed to peacefully protest the lockdown at my capital, but I can go destroy and graffiti my capital. I'm not allowed to go to the park to play T t-ball with my family, but I can destroy the park. I'm not allowed to protect our historical monuments and history, but I can go tear them down and have them land on top of people. I'm not allowed to have an opinion on racial matters because I'm white, but if I don't have an opinion on it, I'm the reason why people are oppressed. I can go riot in the streets with the BLM, but if I go to a Trump rally, COVID-19 magically appears. Does anyone else not see the hypocrisy in all of this? I am done with your bullshit.
And I was just going through. And I saw that this girl here made a response video to that girl's sound that she had just made. And it was very vulgar, I thought. And it was very disrespectful. And so I just reported her video. And it was anonymous too, by the way. It's just anonymous. So I reported it because they did not like it. So I'm just going to show you the video. And I'm not showing it because I'm condoning it. I just want to show you so you can see the comparison of what's happening.
If I say all lives matter, I'm a racist. If I stand for my flag, I have to apologize for it. I'm not allowed to go to church, but I can burn churches to the ground. I'm not allowed to open my own business, but I can go loot and destroy other people's businesses. If I wear...
So I will show you... Okay. So here we go. Oh no. Yeah, so here we go. You report. I anonymously reported Daddy's content for harassment and bullying. I put in who she was bullying. Blah, blah, blah. And then it goes down here. It says, we found that that reported content does not violate our community guidelines. We understand that you may not want to see this type of content, blah, blah, blah. Okay. Then I got a notification saying that I posted a video on 5/25/31 that was removed for violating their community guidelines. Let me show you the video that it was.
Stand up for my home, even if I take this walk alone. I bow down to the king upon the throne.
So I said, okay, that's messed up. Let me submit an appeal because that's ridiculous. So I submitted an appeal. And I said, it was determined that my content violates their guidelines and my cannot be restored. Just ridiculous. It was talking about Bibles and defending people burning Bibles. But the other girl is flipping off, saying F you to churches. And she did not violate any community standards. What is happening to our country?
Flag and Bible burnings, restrictive measures against churches, and the cancel culture. Are these signs America is beginning to abandon its Judeo-Christian roots? Appearing on this week's episode of The Global Lane, author and radio host Eric Metaxas says these recent developments are a wake-up call for the body of Christ.
America is, generally speaking, definitely forgetting its Judeo-Christian roots. But I just want to say, I praise the Lord that these folks are doing these things, because in the past, they would hide this and people would think that, well, they just have a different point of view. By coming out of the closet and doing these brazen, shocking things, they have really stepped into a realm where we can all see precisely what they stand for. When you burn a Bible or burn an American flag, they did both in Portland recently, you have to understand this has very little to do with Christians. The Bible is the book that gave us the West. In other words, whether you're an atheist or an agnostic or a Muslim or a Christian or a Jew, if you live in a place like the United States of America, it's because people took ideas from the Bible. These are God's ideas about self-government and liberty, about having a relationship with the Creator where I govern myself, that led to freedom and led to tremendous prosperity, human flourishing, thriving, the elevation of human dignity. So this is the sort of thing that Christians should be the most alarmed in a sense, but everyone who has a stake in civility, everyone who has a stake in being able to have open debate, to figure out what's actually best for everybody, what's best for the country, Christendom in Europe over the last two millennia, that's what gave us the possibility of creating something like the United States of America. We used to know that as a people, and even not just Americans used to know that. Everyone in Europe, I mean, Churchill would quote the Bible. They knew that when they were fighting totalitarianism, whether it's Hitler or Stalin, they knew what they were fighting. They were fighting a godless, tyrannical view that sees human beings not created in the image of God, as the Bible declares, not created as something that God adores, but on the contrary, as something that can be used for anyone's ends, for the state's ends. You're going to attack churches, you're going to attack Christians. Hitler did precisely the same thing. In my book, Bonhoeffer, I talk about it extensively. He went after the church. He was very wise in the beginning, very canny, but eventually the gloves came off, and you saw the kinds of things in churches like Martin Niemöller's church. The Gestapo would come in there just to threaten them. We see that happening with certain governors in certain states.
Well, let's talk about a couple of those. Let's talk about a couple of those governors in California. Newsom has restricted gatherings in homes to less than 10. Now, that's had an impact on life groups, home Bible meetings. In China, and I've been there a number of times, the Communist Party doesn't become overly concerned with house meetings until they reach 50 or more. So this is worse than China.
Do
you think?
In the United States of America, we are being reminded of what it means to be an American. And again, forgive me for referring to my book, but it's why I wrote my book, If You Can Keep It. I said, we have forgotten what it means to be an American, and we have forgotten to see, to recognize overreach, to recognize when somebody like a governor like Gavin Newsom does something like that, we should all instantly say, that's un-American. You can't do that in America. And by the way, we won't abide by that. We are a free people. If some of us have forgotten, others of us remember, and we will scream and shout until people understand you don't do this in America. You have no right to do this in America. You have no right to say that worshiping God is unnecessary, but casinos are necessary. That's arbitrary. It's the kind of thing that you see in third world dictatorships where, you know, they persecute whoever they want to persecute. We're supposed to have justice for all. We're not supposed to have a double-tiered justice system. All of these things are wake-up calls, mainly for the body of Christ.
Finally then, Eric, what is the solution? I know Bonhoeffer said politics are not the task of a Christian, yet he was involved in the resistance against the Nazis, so that's why he was executed. Should Christians be more engaged in politics?
Christians should be very engaged in politics. The idea of making an idol of politics, that's another story. But any Christian who says, I'm not going to vote because I can't decide, you know, neither of them is perfect enough. If you don't vote, you, Mr. Christian, Mrs. Christian, you are on the hook for whoever gets elected and whoever does tremendously harmful things. If you care about the poor, we are commanded to care for the poor. Who you elect or who you allow to be elected is going to put out policies that are either going to help people get on their feet or are going to harm them and keep them trapped in perpetual bondage to the state, which is what the Democrats have done for over 50 years. So I'm sorry to say we must get involved. And the only reason we have governors like Governor Newsom in California is because evangelicals didn't vote. They're not registered to vote. They didn't vote. This is a scandal, and anything I can do to help people see that is bad theology, that is not biblical theology. You must get involved. God calls us to get involved, if not for our sake, for the sake of all the others who are going to be affected by these horrific, ultimately Marxist policies that elevate the state over the individual and that do not understand what American freedom was or is, and certainly don't want it to continue to be.
I thought the video that we just saw was very eye-opening, and it's just really sad what's happening to Christians. And right now, you guys, in other parts of the world, all over the world, Christians are already being killed or martyred for their faith, like, and murdered in cold blood. China, India especially, really bad. And so we really need to be praying for our brothers and sisters in Christ all over the world. And like the verses that I showed, it says, if they hated you, remember that they hated me first. And it's so true. And, you know, remember again, pray for our church family all over the world. And the world is just continuing to get worse and worse. And as time leads further into this one world religion, watch my previous video on that, but it's going to get to the point where we'll end up dying for our faith more and more. So just stay strong, church family, and then also realize that we have one goal, and that's to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. So no matter how hard it is, we just need to keep persevering, keep pressing forward to the goal. We're almost there, and we just have to keep going and finish this race that we're almost done with. And all my other videos that talk about the signs of the end times, talks about people all around the world getting persecuted for their faith and the ones that are dying. So go check those out. Thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned for future videos. There's a lot of them coming out. And again, don't forget to subscribe. And I will see you guys at my next video. I love you guys. And down in the description is all of the ABCs of salvation. Tomorrow is not promised except Jesus today. Keep looking up, for our redemption draws nigh.